we're gonna go watch some more movies.
Way Too Loud.
Samantha, leave a message.
Fuck you, Jason. I don't need any more of your shit. And don't call me back.
Sorry, not really paying attention, and I'm eating, and I had to go get my earphones. The struggle of your life, my lady.
Psycho outside?
We won't have to walk.
Come on, not him.
Hands where I can see him.
Tom?
Stay where you are and put your hands where I can see them.
Tom, you're making a big mistake.
It's Officer Carter to you, you piece of shit. What happened to you? Are you hurt? Did he do something to you?
It wasn't him. It's someone else. He's hunting us.
Hunting?
You have to get us out of here.
Tom, please, you need to trust us.
Please.
All right. But you're both riding in the back until we can clear all this up.
Thanks, man. I'm sorry if I ever,
Don't. We were kids back then. Besides, you're not off the hook yet.
Oh, my God! It's him again!
What the hell is this?
Now I'm seeing it.
Tom? Tom, take us back to town!
Please, Tom, get in the car and let's get out of here!
Drop your weapons and raise your hands! I said drop your weapons!
Is he dead?
Something's not right.
Let's go, we gotta get to the house.
Anybody's fucking head off. That son of a bitch broke my ribs.
I'm the one shooting fucking heads here. And I'm gonna teach him not to mess with me. And when that motherfucker shows his face, I'm gonna be the last thing he sees before I send him.
Too much fucking talking. I think he doesn't have a face. Wow. Wow. This could be a comedy movie. He really could. Yeah, just give it to him. Yeah, put it just back and do it. Set a firecracker. Thank you.
Fred, do you remember me? Fred, your neighbor. We've known each other since we were kids. We used to play together. Remember, you were the princess. I was your servant. I would carry stuff for you.
Please, Sam, please, you have to believe me. We came here together to spend the weekend. And my parents let us use their cabin so we could have one less vacation before school.
Having a nice weekend until something fell from the sky.
Hey guys, let's go check that shit out. Come on.
I wanted to leave. The rest were curious. We went to see what it was. Tried to convince them we should leave.
See,
this could be dangerous.
That's what I looked like when I came down. Kind of. I looked like
fuck
from the sky.
Science, he said, and did the most stupid thing.
Minus the spiders.
Anymore. I had to hunt them down, and I had to kill them. I had to stop them before they got out to civilization and infected every single one of us. If there's any human left inside you,
no!
Visiting Grandma's house. Unfortunately, others did too. But after saving big with early holiday deals at Amazon, she was ready for those uninvited guests. Who's a good boy? Apparently, the big bad wolf.
Scoring free gas sure feels like a win. At Speedy Glass, we'll throw in a $25 e-card to score free gas when you book a windshield replacement with us. Hurry, this offer ends November 4th. Book your appointment today at speedyglass.ca.
Man, if you understand, you always going after supernatural beings without even knowing the full story, because you have to save your own kind. I feel the same way about my own kind. It's a haunted theater. Whoever gets inside of a movie after.
Yeah.
straight into a movie.
I thought I lost you.
Everybody wants to see the, to have the experience. I think that's what it is.
You too. It's my mother. You're gonna love her.
Champagne. Mm-hmm. I'm moving up in the world.
Oh, the world is just catching up with you to us.
Oh, you're so fucked. Don't you feel like you're royally fucked?
What?
You're royally fucked.
You were looking in the mirror.
We should order dessert. Celebrate.
You have to stop this.
Let's talk about something else.
It's time to let this obsession go.
I'm not the prettiest girl you were ever with, David. Not with...
I don't think like that.
Everyone thinks like that, trust me. But at least let me savor the injustice.
Looks are overrated. Now, your imagination is not always your friend, Anna.
What is it, his gay?
I don't get it.
As happy as you make me.
Making things official between us. It's the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Me too. You know, when I was talking to my mother, she said if you ever want to discuss anything with a plastic surgeon.
You talked about my face with your mother? I'm sorry, I just...
My mother has had work done, Anna. And she understands these things.
You're so handsome. She must have always been beautiful.
Well, she is now. She's extraordinary. Life is too short to worry about what you look like. I will pay for everything.
Then why have the surgery, right?
Anna, Dr. Lanier will see you now. Come on back.
I think we can make you very happy, Anna.
I don't expect miracles. I'm getting married. I just want to look...
Fabulous for the photos. I hear that every day. I've worked on David's wonderful mother. Have you met?
Not yet.
Hmm. Nothing can prepare you for how stunning she looks, if I do say so myself.
Oh, he's being modest. She's a masterpiece.
So what happened?
Car accident. I was two. I don't remember anything other than people staring at me my whole life.
You never considered plastic surgery?
It was financial.
Oh. Well, I'm confident we can eliminate 95% of it.
You're serious?
Yes. You'll hardly know it was there. And if you're willing, since you'll be under, I could make some other adjustments while we're at it.
What woman doesn't have a list?
I want to look beautiful for David.
I would suggest we narrow the nose and give you a bit more chin and cheekbones, of course, for balance.
Really?
It's all about where to put the dermal fillers. I like to inject near the back of the cheek. Gives us volume, not puffiness. You'll love it. I would suggest something more proportional. So I can see it exactly, Anna. You game?
Well, when would we do it?
We're here to make dreams come true. How does next Monday sound?
Soon.
Why wait? We can start the pre-op tests right away.
Which hospital?
You're in it. Our surgery and recovery is all done right here. Yes? Good. Good. Now, any really tough questions?
Well, other than the scar,
Am I doing the right thing? Am I being vain? Am I...
You worry a lot, don't you?
Not a lot. Too much.
Yes, you are doing the right thing. And no, you're not being vain.
What about pain?
Well, we'll give you something to keep you comfortable.
I guess change always hurts a little, one way or another.
A philosopher. I think we're going to be friends.
I'll look.
Anna, you will never dread the mirror again. And David will be the luckiest guy in town. You'll have a nice sleep. We'll take care of everything.
Your handsome fiancé is in the waiting room. Wish I had one of those. Come backwards from 10, honey.
Scuffle.
Our favorite patient.
Hi.
Dr. Lanier has given instructions to change the drains every couple hours. Keep you on something for pain. I just put some in your IV. You let us know, okay? Call button is right there next to the bed. Things went so well, Anna. I'm gonna give you two lovebirds some privacy. Doctor will be in to see you in a few minutes, okay? Oh, and try not to talk, honey. Stitches.
The villa in St. Bart's, it's ours. With our own personal chef. Oh no, don't talk, sweetie.
I love you. I dreamed about us.
We'll speak with him.
I'm very pleased. Everything went well. But we have one small concern. Your oxygen levels. You're not getting quite enough. Happens sometimes with nasal procedures. So why don't we do the smart thing and fix it all tomorrow morning? Get you in and out in no time. Hmm? It's all quite common. Nurse Simone will be here all night, give you something for pain. And I'm scheduled now for another surgery, but she'll call me if anything comes up. You're in good hands.
I had a beautiful dream. But then it got strange. You were there.
When you go under, the mind plays tricks, Hannah. When I had my first plastic surgery, I thought I died and met God. I asked him how he got my job. So, I'll see you in the morning. Sleep. And no worrying. Promise? Mm-hmm.
To make a call.
Doctor says no talking for tonight. Phone's off. Anything else?
A mirror.
Tomorrow. Try to rest.
Clinic, this is Nurse Simone. Be right down.
Doing out of your room.
naughty girl.
Whoa. You know who that girl is? The girl from the shelter with the little face thing.
No, no, please.
Just relax. Everything's going to be fine. More anesthesia, nurse.
No, no,
please. You gotta wait until he heals, babe.
Came to see you. And I want to go get her.
To the family, darling. Oh, she's lovely. Oh, she's just wonderful.
Here?
my nightmare.
Grab and pull it with you.
Please.
Yes.
With me. You're okay.
Help me. I'm scared.
I'm here. Go to your room.
Can I please sleep with you?
I have work to do. I'll see you tomorrow in class, okay? Hey, you know I love you, right?
a good one.
Who's there?
I'm worried about Danny. Peter's suicide was so horrible. I'm frightened. Do you think...
Sister, stop. They're kids. Kids are strong.
Danny, so sad, so sad.
Stop it. Stop it.
What are you gonna do, tell your mommy?
Not again, please, Tanya.
Stop, please. I'm mommy's little baby.
Hey, come back here. Abaddon, the destroyer. Abraxas, the door between two worlds. Mashid. An infernal entity in charge of punishing those who commit lust and incest. Its mission is torturing children and leading them to suicide.
What are you doing in here?
It is Masheed.
No.
It is Masheed. He's torturing Danny and the other children.
Why then? Why now?
I don't know. They're in danger. Please.
It is Masheed. Forces, get away from here. I declare you anathema. Satan, depart from this servant, Peter. Depart! Depart!
He's inside of her. He must kill her before it's too late. Just kill her.
In the shelter of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
What are you doing?
some development.
What are we gonna do? Something's wrong.
Sick.
What am I gonna do with this?
Fight the goddamn devil. Now, do you think we can do it now? First time I didn't like you, but what about now? Grab her and go. Shit.
me. Just stay positive, bro. Everything is a positive attitude. Ha! You did it. Bunch of fucking pedophiles. That's what the fuck that was about.
Good night, children.
Every day is a new day. I like it. So just a priest.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned, and that's why we're here.
What?
Instant Plinko with three exciting levels of play with top prizes of up to $500,000.
Excuse me? Excuse me? Excuse me. Excuse me? My appointment was for 3.
Sorry, Dr. Salvador is running late.
What'd she say, Mom?
A few more minutes.
Yeah, sure. She told you that an hour ago.
Yeah, an hour ago.
Just a few more minutes.
I'm starving.
Looks like they forgot about you.
Don't be silly, honey. I just talked to the woman. She said a few more minutes.
Yeah, sure.
Shouldn't talk back, Eric.
What? All I said was yeah, sure.
You shouldn't say it. It's disrespectful.
Yeah, sure.
I hate to be a pest, but my children are...
Try being patient. What is it now?
I was just thinking that maybe if it's a busy time...
It's not. You're the only one here. Besides, the appointment book's already closed. I can't cross you off now. We did you a favor by squeezing you in. You did say it was an emergency, didn't you?
Yes.
And why would you cancel the appointment?
Sorry.
Mom, I gotta take a shit.
Don't say that word.
Well, I gotta go poop.
I'll take him. No, no. No one goes anywhere without me.
What, not even the men's room?
No, not even.
What?
I don't like the look of it.
Yeah, sure.
The doctor will see you now.
So is that normal that that secretary is covered in dirt?
Come in.
You mentioned something about being afraid.
Yes.
Why are you afraid?
Things keep changing.
Changing how?
Getting different.
Different how? When did you first notice these changes?
Yesterday morning. Things were bad yesterday morning, but then they got better, and now they're getting worse again.
And have you mentioned these changes to your husband?
I don't have a husband. I mean, I had a husband, but he left 2 days ago. My husband has nothing to do with the problem.
Do people around you seem to be changing? Answer the question. Are people around you turning ugly?
Yes.
You hesitated, aren't you sure?
No, I'm just... Sure. How do you know? Do you see it too?
Tell me about your children. Have you noticed similar deformities in them?
Oh, no, not in my children. They look as normal as I do, as normal as you. They brought me here, you know.
How old are they?
9 and 11.
And they brought you here?
Yes. There have been moments in the past few days where they seem very mature.
Mature?
Yes. This morning after I found the...
Go on.
It was Eric who found your number. He made me call you.
And this sudden maturity is the only change you've noticed in them?
Yes. It doesn't last. Usually they act like kids.
And what about everyone else? People other than you and the kids? Is everyone else strangely deformed?
Yes.
And have these changes accelerated since 4 o'clock?
Yes.
And do you consider yourself suicidal?
What is it?
Your colleagues are waiting.
Thank you.
I have a meeting with some field workers, but I'd like to see you again tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
We open at 9, but I want you here at 8:30. Tomorrow, 8:30.
There's something else. You asked if I considered myself.
We can discuss that.
Why won't you help me now?
Thank you.
Tell me! If I'm crazy, just tell me! It'd be so much easier if someone would just... My children?
What children?
My children.
Olha só, minha mulher, muito linda. Tenho pensado muito em você. Uma fantasia muito grande. E te colocar numa cadeira. É, com as cordas. Uma corda bem fininha. Pra amarrar com um jeito bem forte de ser na cadeira. Eu tenho que pegar uma faca e começar a te torturar. Vou escrever meu nome no teu estômago, cortar teus peitos e te fazer comer. Puxar teus olhos de dentro e te fazer comer, sua vadia morta. Depois te dar anestesia. Pegar o alicate e tirar cada um dos teus dentes e te fazer comer. E te deixar lá por um dia inteiro, sofrendo, chorando, se mijando, sem comer nada, sem beber porra nenhuma.
Children.
Próximo dia te jogo água gelada. Taco fogo na tua perna com cigarro. Pra apagar a tua cara. Me espera, puta. Já
eu. I'm asking you a question. Are you ignoring me?
I have a gun, look at me! Is that the worst? The one thing you thought would make you feel powerful and it just doesn't.
Helen. Eric. Thank God. I have to talk to you. I can't.
Helen, what are you doing? You know, it's over, Helen.
Is that her?
Please, Eric, please. What about the children?
What children?
Try to stay sane, are we? Do you feel sane, sweetie?
Too. I only wish we'd given her poison instead of a gun. She won't take poison. She needs to do something aggressive.
How many bullets were there in the gun?
One. That's all she'll need, provided she doesn't miss.
And provided she uses it on herself. You know, in a way, I feel sorry for her. It's not her fault she descended.
It's no one's fault. Descent from the higher realities is neither fair nor unfair. It's a fact. It happens. It's up to us to deal with it or pass judgment.
Do you think her husband deserting her caused it?
It's possible. Have you read Dr. Pico's study on traumatic descent?
No.
Do so.
I love this.
If you can make field work a career, you'd be wise to keep up on the literature.
Just keep thinking it'd be so much better if we could just elevate her back.
Yeah, sure. How are we gonna do that if we don't even know what the reality she came from?
We might be able to figure it out. We know she had a family. We know she had two boys, Eric and Chris. We know she loved them. You don't know that. We can infer it. Have you seen the way she looks at us? It's not the way she looks at other things. She's seen the children she left behind.
She told me about that when we talked. She told me that I looked normal. I believe that she only heard some of what I said to her. She's having auditory as well as visual hallucinations.
Are you sure that suicide is the only option?
It's the only practical one. There's a slight chance, a theoretical chance, that she could return the way she descended. It has happened, but it would take a resilience she doesn't have.
So we have to kill her?
No. She has to kill herself. The physician is not murderous.
Well, where is she now?
Right outside the door in the hallway, listening.
Hold set!
Open the door, see for yourself. I heard her moving out there.
That. Chris. I warned you, Chris. I warned you about that kind of talk. Come on. Mom! Mom, where are we going? Home.
You're not listening. Hard. How you doing, babe? No way. You have a good bad day, don't you?
Ticket with three exciting levels of play with top prizes of up to $1 million.
I love this.
Absolutely wonderful tonight, honey.
Great, son. I mean, just great. Best by far.
It's not a competition, Dad.
Don't kid yourself. Life is a competition. And don't you forget that. So who was that composer? New guy or old guy?
New guy.
European?
American. I wrote it, Dad. Yeah.
Wait, you wrote that?
Yeah.
Wow, that's pretty good for an American.
I'm glad you can make it, Dad.
I wouldn't have missed it for the world, son.
Get out of the car!
Whoa, whoa!
Don't fucking look
okay,
at me! Get out
okay.
of the car!
Hey! All right, just everybody calm down, okay? Okay, okay.
Get out of the car.
Please don't hurt my son!
Get out!
Here we go, kamikaze Jesus.
Get on the ground! Take what you want! Get on the floor, don't look at me.
Riley, please don't hurt us, don't hurt us!
Oh. There you go.
Who's awake? Can you hear me, son? Just nod your head if you can. All right.
Where's my mom? she still here?
No, no, your mother's not here.
Did she go home?
You know, son, you need to rest. We'll talk later, okay?
I'm just glad she's still alive.
Okay.
My dad. He's dead, isn't he?
Not really.
I was afraid that he'd kill both of them.
Just rest, son. We'll talk later. Just go ahead and close your eyes and rest. That's what you need to do now.
Maybe you should go back to bed, mister. You're gonna hurt yourself.
What are you doing out here? You should be in bed.
That man, the one with all the stitches.
A lot of stitches in this place, but I don't know what you're talking about.
He was right there.
Those meds make you dreamy. Let's get that little butt back in bed, mister. I don't need no sorry. What I need is for you to stay put. You are lucky to be alive, mister. Go back to bed, Casey. There's nothing for you to see here.
Oh, have you got a new heart?
Come on. Oh, Jesus. Come on, baby. Come on. It's all right. Come here. It's okay.
Are you a dead guy's heart?
You, my little pile of Riley.
Love you too, Mom.
So come be with me.
That time, hon, moving day. Time for you to go to a regular room. This is ICU, young man, not the Ritz-Carlton. You're getting better. Gotta make room for the people in need. You're lucky to be alive, you know? You were dead on that operating table till they brought you back.
I was dead?
Your heart stopped for a full 17 minutes. Did you hear the choir? Did you see the white lights? But you're alive now. Somebody upstairs likes you. Thank you.
Dad? My dad's dead, isn't he?
Not now, hon.
I saw that guy shoot him. He's dead, isn't he? I'm not a baby. I saw his brains. He's dead, isn't he?
Stop it, son. That talk ain't doing nobody no good.
Where's my mom?
That's enough, son. Calm down.
Like how you changed into a person who calls their car baby, and how COVID-19 keeps changing too. That's why Moderna created the new bivalent booster to protect against multiple variants. This fall, choose to boost.
Sleeping, kid? I got flowers and shit.
Sir, you cannot have flowers in here. Are you family?
I'm a family friend.
Immediate family only after 7. This boy's got a lot of healing to do, and those daffodils ain't gonna help. Go on home, come back in the morning, and leave the flowers there. It's okay, hon. Go back to sleep.
Him too, don't you?
The dead guys.
You can see them?
Oh, yeah. What's your name?
Riley Everson.
I'm Casey. So how long were you dead?
17 minutes. How'd you know?
It takes one to know one. I was only gone for 6.
You were dead too?
You're safe.
All the best people have been dead and back, right? You look like you need to sit down. So, how did you die?
I got shot.
Jesus. Who would want to shoot a kid?
He killed my dad and maybe my mom. I think I was the only person that lived.
Shit, that's fucked up.
So, how did you...
How did I die?
You try to kill yourself?
No, well, for 6 minutes, I did kill myself.
Why?
Because everybody lies. People only tell you they love you when they want something from you.
So, why do you think we can see them? The dead guys?
I've been thinking about that a lot. So I think that they're lost, like in between where you live and where you die. Maybe we can see them because we were there too. I think they know where we've been and they want to get some of what we got. I don't even think they know they're dead.
I saw my mom.
Really?
When she touched me, I could feel it. It was really cold.
Did she talk to you?
Mm-hmm. She told me that she loved me and that she wanted me to be with her.
If she's, like, dead, I don't think that's such a good thing.
Maybe she's not dead?
Maybe. I think you should sleep. You look like shit. But if you get lonely or scared or something, just come over to Casa Casey, okay?
Really?
Us living dead, we gotta stick together.
Right.
Night, Riley.
Night, Casey.
Hi, Riles.
Hi, Mom.
I miss you, honey.
But you're dead.
Everything is okay, sweetheart. I promise. I want you to close your eyes, relax, go to sleep.
You're so tired.
Come on, baby. I need you to come be with me. There won't be any pain anymore. Just relax, let go. No more pain.
Leave him alone! Riley, wake up! She wants you dead! She wants you to be dead with her! Don't let her take you!
Wake up, sleepyhead. Time for breakfast. Casey, leave the boy alone. Go on back and have your breakfast. Go on now. Leave the boy be and let him heal.
I'll see you later, Riley, okay?
That girl is trouble, little mister, and I suggest you keep your distance.
I think she's nice.
Mm-hmm. Looks like she finished the job.
Thank you.
You're not in here, are you, kid?
Long movie.
Kid.
What's going on? Am I dead?
Dead? Kid, you ain't never been more alive. But then... yeah, they're all dead.
I want to get out of here.
Do you think you can escape the future that's already been told? Then you run, Riley. You run, boy, now. Run! Go, you little motherfucker!
Oh no.
I'm a little speechless, so I'm just gonna go to bed. Bye.